In the continuation of memory management, we'll see different memory management technique. So why we do memory management? So the requirement of memory management is for the allocation of program into the memory. So how we can allocate the memory to the program, that is the memory management. So if we'll talk about different memory management techniques, so we have two type of technique. One is categorized into contiguous memory allocation. And the second one is called non-contiguous memory allocation. Now, the continuous memory allocation means we allocate the continuous memory or contiguous memory for the program or for our process to be stored. In the contiguous memory allocation, we have two type of partition into the memory. The first partition is called fixed. Partition. Another is called variable size partition. One is called fixed size, you can say fixed size partition. And the second one is called variable size partition. The fixed size partition is also called static partition, and this is called dynamic partition. Here, what will happen is the memory that is partitioned into the fixed size, and here the memory is not partitioned, it is based on the process size, the partition will be done. In the non-contiguous memory allocation, where the program will be stored in a non-contiguous fashion, we have different techniques. So we are going to learn paging. Then we have multi-level paging. Then we have another category, which is called inverted paging. And then we have segmentation and segmented paging. So another one is called segmentation, and then we have segmented paging. So there are different techniques in memory management where we allocate the memory to the process. It means that how we are storing or how we are putting the processes or the program into the memory. This is the memory management techniques. Now let's go first to the contiguous memory allocation. So what is contiguous memory allocation that we'll see. Now what happened into the contiguous memory allocation, you just consider as an array. So array, we know that it is a example of contiguous memory allocation, right? So in this contiguous memory allocation, what we do is, let's say we have a program P1, the size of that program is, let's say 2 KB, And we have, let's say, program two. The size of this is, let's say, 4 KB. So what we do is, we allocate the memory of, means we allocate into the contiguous memory. Let's say P1 is allocated here, or let's say P2 is allocated here. Means the program P1 is allocating into the contiguous allocation and in contiguous memory, as well as P2 is also stored in a contiguous memory. If you'll talk about, let's say P3 also came, the size is, let's say, 5 kilobyte. So let's say I'm storing into somewhere here, let's say P3, that is stored here. So you can see that the program or the process is stored into the memory in a contiguous allocated memory. Now, if we'll talk about non-contiguous memory allocation, so you consider the linked list. So what happened into the linked list? We have two part in the linked list. One is the data part and another is pointer. Pointer is pointing to the next node. In that way, the linked list is there, right? A linked list is made of. So what happened here is, let's say one part of the program we are storing in one place, another part we are storing in another place. Let's say we have the chunk of memory. The available portion of the memory is called hole. So we have to search for the hole. Let's say if we have some memory which is already occupied here. Let's say it is of 10 kilobyte of memory. Some memory is also already occupied. Let's say it is of 2 kilobyte, which is already occupied. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So all are of 2 kilobyte. Let's assume that. So if I want to store the 2 kilobyte, I can store it here, right? Because the size is 2 kilobytes, so it can accommodate here. Now, if I want to accommodate this, the 4 kilobyte, so in a contiguous memory allocation, I don't have the place where I can store. But if we have non-contiguous memory allocation, so what we do is, we store the portion of the P2 here of 2 KB, and the rest of P2 I can store here in 2 KB. And this portion, we have a pointer which is pointing to the next location here. So this is how your non-contiguous memory allocation will be done. And here comes the concept of paging and segmentation. So that we'll see later on. Let's see the definition of contiguous memory allocation and non-contiguous memory allocation, and what are the problem that they are facing. So in the contiguous memory allocation is basically a method in which a single contiguous section part of the memory is allocated to a process or a file needed it. Because of this, all the available memory space reside at the same place together, which means that the free unused available memory partition are not distributed in a random fashion here and there across the whole memory space. We can achieve contiguous memory allocation by dividing the memory partition into fixed partition, as well as we have the concept of variable partition size. So we have the concept of fixed partition, or you can say the dynamic allocation also we can do with the help of the variable partitioning side or variable size partition. Okay, so this is contiguous. What happened into non-contiguous memory allocation? In the non-contiguous memory allocation is basically a method on a contradictory of the contiguous memory allocation. It allocates the memory space present in a different location to the process as per its required. As all the available memory space is in a distributed manner, so the freely available memory space is also scattered here and there. So because here we are talking about the memory spaces, we may not find in a contiguous manner. So the non-contiguous memory allocation will help me to accommodate those processes. But what happened in the contiguous memory allocation? I need the contiguous memory which should be free so that I can accommodate all those processes in at once. So this is the idea behind contiguous memory allocation and non-contiguous memory allocation. Now let's talk about the method that we are using is the fixed partition and the variable size partitioning in a contiguous memory allocation. So now